Michigan Trophy takes center stage in today's football contest. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Michigan is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. He's to the 40. The 50. Inside the 30. For the 10. And he will score.
Was simply sensational running, and it shows you what kinds of major things can happen when you have a good ground game.
And he tacks on the extra point. Michigan State to kick. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Kirk, today we get to watch one of the great wide receivers in college football. Collins' footwork, his great hands, his speed, he is a dangerous offensive weapon.
No doubt, Brad. He is really one of the most exciting players to watch in college football. He catches everything that's thrown his way and is a legitimate deep threat downfield to make big plays for this offense. He's going to face some double, sometimes even triple team coverage. And I think today, this defense, they might do a decent job of slowing him down, but eventually, he's too dangerous. He's going to make some big plays.
What a play.
What a play is right. Here they throw the ball to the tight end, and the big guy shows that he's valuable not only as a blocker, but as a receiver as well. Nice catch.
Over the middle, got his tight end. Brought down at the 41.
That brings up second and one.
The defense jumped, but I think a lineman moved first.
Defense.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. He's scrambling. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And he's taken down around the 28-yard line. Good game there on the quarterback scramble.
You know, I really like the decision to tuck it and run here. He waited and found no one open, so instead of throwing it away, he just took it upfield for himself.
Looks left, picked off.
It's a great job in coverage by this linebacker. He does a good job of reading the quarterback's eyes and is able to come up with the interception.
From their own 27-yard line. First down, Michigan State is up a score. Lombardi with the play fake, and he's leveled at the 40-yard line.
I'll tell you something, I'm loving this quarterback's confidence more and more as this game goes on. He's really throwing the ball with some purpose.
He makes it to the 42-yard line. He gains a couple of yards on the carry.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 42-yard line. Second down. Throws it out and it falls incomplete.
I know this quarterback trusts his arm and his receivers, but he's got to know when not to throw the ball. He didn't have any room at all, and he's lucky it wasn't intercepted.
From the 42-yard line, first down. Nice run to the left there.
Gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
Taken down at the 29-yard line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Hands This is the eighth play of the drive. Tackle around the 27-yard line.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
From the 27-yard line, second down. Michigan State up 7 points. Because it looks like they came ready to play today. 7-0, Michigan State. And we're ready for more football here in quarter number two. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires quickly and it's picked off. And he tackles him hard at the 21-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 21-yard line. To the 30. He's to the 40. And they push him out around the 48-yard line.
This back might need a breather after that run. But when he comes back, just give it to him again.
And down he goes at the 44.
That makes it second and two.
Tackled at the 33-yard line.
I think play action is a big part of this offense and what they're trying to do tonight. You know, they're running the football and they're mixing in some play action. And what that does is it freezes the linebackers and the safeties and puts a lot of pressure on them to have to be able to defend both the run and the play action. And as a play caller, when I know I can go to play action fast, boy, I feel really good about it. It's getting my quarterback in rhythm, slowing down the defense, and giving us a chance to make big plays.
Here's a quick throw. Finds the junior. He's all the way. Touchdown.
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding its playmaker for the score.
It was a pretty simple route, but they run it to perfection for the score. We'll be tied with the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. A five-play, 79-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown.
And he makes it out to about the 17-yard line. The offense will take the field, hoping for a better result than their last drive.
And I don't think this defense will lay down lightly. They're going to try to continue to rattle this guy.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
That's a gain of four on the play. That makes it second and six.
Second down and six. Ball on the 21. Fires out to his receiver. And they bring him down right around the 42-yard line. With room to work, and they make the stop around the 47-yard line. From the 47-yard line, it's first down. Got a man, get him out of his hands.
Number 8, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
About 4 yards away here on third down. Caught out in the open. Tackle made at the 30-yard line.
Thomas makes the tackle at the 39. First down.
They come out in an empty backfield. Throws out, got his back again. He's tackled around the 18-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 18. And he hits him hard at the 7-yard line. And this is the ninth play of the current drive. This one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Collins' struggles continue now. We're almost at halftime, Kirk, and he just hasn't been able to establish himself as any part of the offense, and right along with him, the offense is struggling and trying to find their identity.
Yeah, we all know that football is definitely a team game, and it's really not fair to put all this team's performance on just one player. I mean, if this guy is the emotional leader of this team, it seems like with him not being involved as much in the offense, I think it's really starting to affect him just by looking down and watching his body language on the sidelines. And you never want your teammates to see your frustrations like that or your opponent. So let's look for this coaching staff to try to talk to him, try to calm him down at halftime. I think we need to inject a little bit of life to try to affect him and his team if they want to come back and win the second half.
Michigan's going to have to use their second time out of the half. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And he's immediately tackled.
Person makes the tackle at the 39-yard line. First down.
Complete. He's got room to work. Brought down around the 33-yard line. So we've played two quarters. Michigan State in front, 14-7.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always. To lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around, too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
Just about time to start the second half. What do you think Herb Street's first point of analysis will be?
I don't know, something to do with quarterback play, I'm sure. We always got to hear that stuff all the time. It's all about the quarterbacks.
Brad and Kirk ready for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Fires it out. And he's taken down at the 35-yard line.
Person makes the tackle at the 35-yard line. First down. First and 10.
makes it to the 48-yard line.
That's a gain of two. That makes it 7-8.
Makes it to the 31.
On the play, and I think they might want to reassess the strategy here. Perhaps run a screen, maybe hit the tight end on a short pattern. This D-line is just a bit much to handle at this moment.
Makes the catch, and he might take it. He's at the 20. Spectacular play, and now it's first and goal.
First and on the tackle at the 6-yard line. That makes it first and goal.
He tackles him for a loss. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 10. Across the middle, caught it, touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And it takes some real accuracy on those deep corner routes. So kudos to the quarterback. He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. He's to the 10. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 23. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Nice run there. Collins gets 6 yards on the carry.
That'll make it 7-4.
So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Catches it, and he's looking for more. He's taken down at the 39. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Fit it in there, and it'll be intercepted.
I really like this corner's ability to read the play. He shows very good football smarts and pretty good hands, too.
They'll get him for a loss.
Well, the defensive line got such a good push up front that there was no one on the offense to account for the linebacker, and he got through almost untouched.
Second down at 12. Ball on the 43. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
They really pounded him on that throw. Play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
So with one quarter remaining, we're deadlocked right now at 14. Well, this final few minutes is going to determine this one. Tight ball game. Action set to start here in the fourth quarter. Just under 3 to go in regulation. It's away, and it's a booming punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Here we are early in the fourth quarter in a very, very tight ball game. And every possession is going to count from here on out. Got it. And he goes down quickly. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Five wide. Tackle the 39-yard line. And down he goes at about the 39-yard line.
That's good enough for another Michigan State.
First and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. Got a man. Watch out here. And he's tackled around the 10-yard line. Second down and 10 to go. 10 yards to the end zone. Touchdown, Michigan State. What a huge play on the ground for the touchdown. And he hits the PAT. Michigan State gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 33. The Wolverines have sort of set up the defense with this wide receiver doing most of the damage. Do they go away from him or do they do something different?
I think one of two things here for this offense. You either find a way to get your star receiver the football, or in some cases you want to use him as a decoy, maybe take two or three defenders with him, and then open it up for somebody else to be able to make a play.
Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. And he's leveled at the 46-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 13 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Receiver, and that's a first down.
That's pretty impressive. Accuracy is important, but just as important as having receivers that can make plays.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Now he tries to buy some time. That's a great tackle at the 44-yard line.
Oh, that is a big hit on the quarterback. That's one of those as an offensive lineman, when the film study starts to come around, you're going to kind of sink in your chair and just hope they don't call you out because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday.
Pulls it in and stops in his tracks with that tackle. Michigan will take their first time out of the half. Biggest third down and long of the football game right here in the fourth quarter. Jumped out of bounds around the 41-yard line.
That'll make it fourth and 10.
They'll need something really big here out of their quarterback on fourth and one. They'll bring him down around the 17-yard line. The Wolverines are going to call their second timeout. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 17-yard line. Throws out to the back, and he can't hold out
of it. That makes it second and 10.
This is the eighth play of this drive. Under a minute left. Scrambling around.
slides down. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. Middle to the running back.
So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win.
The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. Michigan's called their final timeout. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. So this one's in the books, and we saw a great one here today. 21-14, Michigan State. As we take a look at the highlights, Kirk, how would you summarize the action of this one?
Michigan State came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
That's it for this presentation of NC.